Hello there, friend. You remember my brother and me from downstairs? With Harkon, right?
Sorry it had to be this way.
We don't like it any more than you do. Well, maybe a little more.
This sounds vaguely like a threat. What did I ever do to you guys?
I'm sorry, girl. I liked you. I really did.
But Harkon made us a deal, see? We kill you, we go home.
If you're going to kill me, then do it.
I'm sorry. I really am.
Quiet, Balak. The time for talk is past. Fight for your life, acolyte.
Look who shows up at long last. I half expected to hear you'd crossed some dark lord upstairs and finally got yourself killed. None of the others have shown up either. I assume they're dead by now, which means you and Fon are the last ones.
So I just kill Fon and I'm Sith, right? This shouldn't take long.
Wrong. Your final trial will be to retrieve an ancient map from the innermost chamber of Naga Sado's tomb, which has never been breached in thousands of years. But before you get the map, you'll have to awaken an ancient assassin called a Dashard that sleeps in the tomb. You cannot access the map without him. Understand?
What exactly is a Dashard?
They're a lost race of assassins that the ancient Sith used to devour their force-using enemies. This one will probably eat you the moment he's freed. Oh, and one more thing. You'll be competing with Fon for this map. Whoever brings it back will be Lord Zash's apprentice. The other will die. And Fon's already started, so my advice? Run, slave. Run.
One moment, please.
Lord Zash, what are you doing here?
Overseer, are you implying that I, a Lord of the Sith, don't have the right to go where I please within the Academy of the Sith?
No, of course not, Lord Zash.
Good. I saw the last acolyte arrive. I wanted to see the hopefuls off on their final trial. Where's, the red one, Fawn?
He finished his trial early, so I sent him on rather than keeping him waiting for this.
Pity. I just finished translating the wonderful text this acolyte brought from Tulak Horde's tomb, and it's most illuminating. I don't know that the map can be retrieved without it.
What makes you say that?
It's too late. Fon's already left. You can't just...
Give one acolyte an unfair advantage over the other? Overseer, when has being Sith ever been about being fair? Now, my dear acolyte, here is what you must do to free the Dashard. There are rods scattered throughout the tomb of Naga Sado. These rods are the keys to the chamber where the ancient assassin is imprisoned. You will need to place the rods in the chamber door and electrify them. I don't know exactly the reason, but it is clear that you will not be able to retrieve the map without the Dashard. But be careful, he is very dangerous.
Is there anything else I should know about the Dashard?
It's a force-resistant assassin. I have reason to believe this one was placed in the tomb by Tulak Horde himself. I will return when both acolytes are back from the tomb. You will not do anything further to affect the outcome of the trial. Understood?
Yes, Lord Zash.
Good. And good luck, acolyte.
Acolyte. May I speak to you for a moment? Of course you can. Thank you. I'm honored that you would do me the courtesy. There was another acolyte, not long ago, who entered this tomb and did not come back. He died in there.
What caused his death?
I don't know, but I could tell he was dying. I heard him scream, even through the great tomb doors. The acolyte who went in there, he was a good sort. friendly and talkative. He said he was entering the tomb to prove himself to his father. I just thought it would be nice if somebody took his body back and told his father he didn't make it.
Yes, the father should be told that his son has fallen.
I'd never survive in there. And even if I did, I wouldn't be allowed to see his father. He is a Dark Honor Guard stationed in the Academy. None but Sith can ever set foot on the sacred ground where he stands watch. But you could find the body and bring it to his father. Please, do this and honor the fallen.
I can absolutely do that.
Thank you so much. If you find the Acolyte's remains inside the tomb, let me know. I can tell you where to find his father in the Academy. Good luck.
I'm an Acolyte now, but I'll be Sith soon.
Yes,
could you try to explain things from the beginning? What happened then? If Prythor's the one who exiled you to these caves, I doubt he'll change his mind about feeding you. If Prythor is really behind all this, he may be worth investigating.
Yes,
you found him. That poor Acolyte.
Yes, yes. One dead Acolyte.
His father was Naaman Fall. As I said before, he's one of the Dark Honor Guards in the Academy. If you take the Acolyte's remains to his father, I'm sure he'll be grateful.
Sounds like a worthy cause.
Thank you. It's good to see that there are more feelings embraced by the Sith than just hate and fury. You can find the Acolyte's father outside the chamber of the Dark Council. That's where he stands guard.
You don't belong here. You stand before the Chamber of the Dark Council, and this floor is off limits to all who are not lords of the Sith. If you are not on official business, you will leave now.
I've come with news about your son.
So that is the smell you carry. It is said he went into the tomb of Naga Sadao to prove himself, and was killed. He was such a weak boy. He shames me in death as he shamed me in life. When I heard of his death, I could not leave my post. Honor forbade it. Still, I would like to know what happened in there.
Of course. Ask away, my lord.
Your deference does you credit. Now tell me, where did you find his body? Did my pathetic son even make it past the first steps? In the end, was he Sith?
He died right at the entrance of the tomb. Pathetic indeed.
Of course he did. Every moment of his life existed only to mock me. I will keep his bones to remind me of my shame and to focus my anger. But you have done me a service, and such deeds should be repaid. You have brought me pain and torment. I will return the favor. My son sought a relic I placed in the base of a cracked statue, deep in the tomb. This crystal will release it. Now go.
What do you want? I'm training slaves to feed the beasts, and I don't have time to chat.
Have you heard of a creature called Seirun?
Seirun? You know of Seirun? That creature was close to me when I was an acolyte. It helped me survive my trials. It traveled places I couldn't, told me everything it heard and saw. It had been living off vermin before I came along. I figured out a way to make it healthier, stronger. Seirun's special meals.
What is Seirun exactly? I've never seen anything like it.
Its people come from the planet Biss, but it's lived on Korriban as long as anyone can remember. Seirun never knew exactly what I fed it. Its meals weren't just beast fodder. Seirun ate the corpses of the Academy's failures, the bones and blood of dead acolytes. Feeding on their energy after death, it grew exponentially more powerful with every meal, and became strong in the dark side.
You fed the corpses of dead students to that thing?
The sludge we feed to the slaves and the two Carter wouldn't have sated Seirun. And bodies pile up quickly here. It was an easy way to dispose of them. When I saw how twisted Seirun was becoming, I sent it away. It was becoming hungrier all the time, and I feared it would attack the living. Destroying it seemed impossible. It could heal any injury it suffered. I hoped it would find a new home somewhere. But it seems we must act more decisively.
What's your plan?
Aid Seirun and it will turn on us. One more taste of power and it will begin hunting acolytes. I can't allow that. Together, we must poison Seirun. Before I sent Seirun away, I developed a powerful toxin, but I didn't have the heart to use it. It won't kill the creature, but it should strip it of its power.
Seirun helped you. It adored you. How can you be so ungrateful?
If I thought I could keep that thing, I would. I tried, but Seirun isn't what it used to be. Poisoning it would be merciful. If we do this, Seirun won't survive much longer. It will hide as best it can and slowly starve. But the alternative is to let it become a living horror.
Then let's poison that thing.
I'm glad you see it as I do. I'm giving you this meat. Don't ask me where it came from, but it should fool Seirun. Once the poison is in its system, it will weaken. I take no satisfaction in this, but it is necessary.
It's right here. Have it. I did what was necessary. You just need to learn to deal.